When people think of Manulife, I think they tend to think of insurance, but you've been doing banking for quite some time, is that right?
Yes, Barb. We've been in Manulife Bank just celebrated our 26th anniversary.
I thought it had been a while, but you're just about to roll out something new that you're talking about taking on the big five banks. I'm wondering if you can talk to me a little bit about that, because when I hear things like that, all I can think about are sort of the, not exactly the bodies strewn, but the competitors, the would-be competitors that have either left the country or been swallowed up by the big banks. I'm thinking credit card portfolios. I'm thinking even the upstart banks like ING Direct, which is now Tangerine at Scotia. CIBC bought President's Choice Financial. How do you take on the big banks in Canada?
Yeah, well, we see this as a natural evolution. You know, in our 26 years, we've come out with products that are designed to be in the best interests of the customers. This new product set that's coming out, this digital banking package, all in banking, is designed to attract millennials, maybe people that don't necessarily own homes today, but an innovative digital offering, four accounts or four products open in 4 minutes, and you're good to go. All with unlimited transactions. There's the fee for everything unlimited is only $10 a month. And if you save $100, we're gonna waive that fee.
How do you think you're sort of gonna get in when there actually is more competition from the likes of the fintechs than there has been in the past?
Yeah, well, actually what we've done, we partnered with four fintechs from around the world so that we could deliver this incredible digital offering to our consumers. So as a result of all this put together, our customers will receive this package of unlimited transactions of all kind, including interact email transfers, and together with that, we're providing them with travel insurance and have embedded digital artificial intelligence to help them with their cash flow needs.
So how are the products actually gonna work? Like, what do I do if I sign up? What do I get?
Yeah. So, you know, what we're doing is, you know, we are, you know, if you ask who our target audience is, it is customers that are dealing with the big banks today. Simply the value we're offering is unbeatable in the marketplace. We have this unique digital offering that provides people advice and these little cards that on their mobile device that shows like a Instagram or a Tinder type card where you swipe and you swipe and it comes right in your face saying, here's how you're spending your money, here's how close you are to your credit limit, and we go beyond that. We're offering unlimited transactions of any kind for $10 a month. However, if you save $100 only in any 1 month, we will waive the $10. And we are putting, every time you sign on to your phone, you're going to see how close you are to that $100.
So I know fees are a big issue for customers of the big banks. There's always been complaints about how expensive it is to bank. And we do hear that about Canada in particular. So was there a rationale to putting the $10 fee on there in the first place? Or is there a way to sort of capture customers by, has this been tried before, I guess, is what I'm wondering in terms of like waiving a fee or not having one or having lower fees. How did you settle on what you're going to do now?
Well, what we wanted to do is we wanted to encourage millennials to save money. They tell us that they need help in saving money. So we are encouraging them to save as little as $100 and put it into their savings account. And if they put it in their savings account, there's no fee involved. So in fact, we've even programmed it so that they can tell us how much they want to keep in their everyday banking account, and anything over that amount will automatically sweep it out the night before and put it into their savings account. So what we're doing is we're providing Canadians with incredible value here that they're not getting today from the big banks.
So it's that kind of nudge idea where you get them to save without them sort of realizing that they have the money in the first place?
Yeah, there's a natural evolution. We built on technology that we can actually enhance the technology every 2 weeks. And some of the enhanced insight that's coming in the future is exactly that. At the rate you're spending money, you may go into an overdraft. Or you have an extra $100 that you're not spending each month. Would you like us to put it into your savings account? Exactly that.
Well, I'm wondering about this product at this particular time, because I think I've seen research, and some of it may even have come from Manulife Bank, where people are having trouble putting away enough money for a rainy day. Like even they're coming up short. They don't have one sort of $50 for an emergency if they experience that. So is it your thought that they actually could have the money, or is it that, you know, pay hasn't been going up and people simply don't have the money? They're taking on more debt because they don't have access to the funds.
the group we're looking at, they need encouragement to save money. Perhaps they're spending discretionary money as opposed to information, I mean, stuff they have to spend, actual like rent and stuff like that. So we're encouraging them. We're giving them artificial intelligence that they can look at and say, where am I spending my money? You can text in saying, how much money did I spend on fast food last month? And so people will get a greater awareness of where their money's going.
And so do you see your competition as the big banks and the fintechs? Because that sounds a bit like some of the fintech experience that I've heard about, where they're trying to sort of give people AI access to their spending habits and tracking, that sort of thing.
Right. We absolutely see the big banks and their customers of the big banks as our target audience. We're partnering with fintechs. There are other fintechs out there, but none of them offer the total essential banking package that we're offering: savings, checking, ATMs, all of that, all in one package together with the artificial intelligence.
And can you talk a bit about the consumer debt situation and anywhere else that you may be positioning yourself to sort of address that in terms of people's just overall indebtedness in Canada?
Yeah, well, for a lot of that is housing debt. And Manulife Bank is famous for our Manulife One mortgage, which has an offset product where any money that's sitting in your checking or savings account is automatically applied against your mortgage on any particular day. So we are actually helping Canadians save thousands of dollars through the key amount that they owe on their housing generally.
So is that going to be part of this new savings account that's going to do that as well, where they're putting away the extra $100 to try to get the fee waived, or is that a separate?
We see people graduating to that. You know, this package is focused on people that don't have a lot of money. They generally don't own a home yet, but this is an opportunity for them to start saving for a home. And as they graduate and buy a home, then we can help provide them with those unique tools that are not offered by any other bank.
Can you talk about who the fintechs are that you're partnering with and what the nature of the partnership is?
Yeah, sure. Well, we have two sets of fintech partners. I would say two in the Canadian space, two companies both in Montreal. One is called SecureFact and the other is Flinks, that specialize in the digital ID regulatory space. And the other two are artificial intelligence companies, one that's based in the US and the other in Singapore. We're using a company out of New York called Casisto, and there's a company that was formed by some ex-BNP Paribas guys in Singapore, and they really know banking, and that's called MoneyThor.
And I guess I would ask a couple of timing questions. One would be, how long have you been sort of putting this together before you're in a position to roll it out? I guess the second thing would be, is it rolling out across Canada?
Yeah, absolutely. It's rolling out June 10th across Canada. Available. It's digital, so it's available everywhere in Canada. And we've been working on this for over 2 years now. We wanted to look around the world, see what was there. This has been designed by customers. We've also worked with our Manulife Bank Innovation Lab, Red Lab, in Kitchener. And we continually went back and interacted with our customers and our potential customers, saying, what do you think about this feature? What do you want? And as a result, this is very much designed by Canadians for Canadians.
And in terms of the future, are you just, is your plate full with this as far as the bank, or where do you see it going?
No, absolutely not. We've developed this product and other products through an agile methodology. So we are committed to continually enhancing our products and services ongoing. We're actually going to notify our customers and tell them what's coming next and what we're developing next, and then get input on whether they want to see that or they want to see something different. So we're not standing still. We're the best alternative to the big banks today.